Dear friends, welcome to the next session for software engineering and designing concepts. So in the previous session, we completed with the basic software lifecycle development models and discussed briefly about various phases. So, and we also did a comparative study between various models. In today's session, we will be discussing about the next phase of the software development lifecycle, which is the requirement analysis and specification phase. So let's get started. Requirement analysis and specification phase is that particular phase in a software development lifecycle which is responsible for gathering the requirements from the customer and then analyzing them and specifying them in a particular document. Now, most projects fail as the developers start developing without the full knowledge of the system or customer requirements. Now, it is essentially important for the developers and the customers to come to a common conclusion related to the various functionalities that the software or the project might be offering. In order to do so, there has to be n number of discussions with the customer through interviews or survey forms or various question answer rounds, so that the developers or the designers get a clear idea of what the customer actually wants. So basic goals of this phase is to understand the user requirements fully and then remove inconsistencies, anomalies, etc. from the mentioned requirements. Now it is important for us to understand that the customer requirements are not fully complete whenever they provide the first instance of requirements to the developers. So it is important for a system analyst to identify if there are any inconsistencies and anomalies and report back to the customer so that this can be commonly sorted out. The third important goal is documenting the requirements in an SRS. Now, this is very important from the perspective of the developer as well as the maintenance team, because based on the software requirements specification, the developers will be able to add new features if required, and the maintenance team would be able to maintain the software product without any problem. And they can refer to the SRS whenever they feel like or whenever they require while adding any new functionality to it. This is also the exit criteria of this particular phase. That means once this phase is completed, the developers should make sure, or the system analyst, whoever is dealing with the phase, should make sure that this SRS is formed, and only after this SRS is designed and documented, we would be able to exit this particular phase and move to the next phase. So talking about the activities of this phase, it involves requirement gathering and analysis and requirement specification. So requirement gathering and analysis essentially relates to the gathering and analysis done by the system analyst in collaboration with the customer, so that this phase gives a fruitful outcome from the customer in terms of the requirements that are required by them. The next phase is the requirement specification, and this phase essentially refers to the SRS of the particular project. Now, SRS refers to the software requirement specification, and basically it is a document which needs to be filled in a systematic and a specific manner, so that the developers and the designers and all the stakeholders of that particular project are capable of understanding the entire flow, the various functional requirements, non-functional requirements, as well as other environmental requirements related to that particular project. So the system analyst basically does the requirement gathering and analysis part. So system analyst is basically a person who is designated and deployed in order to gather the requirement. It might be through various questionnaires or survey forms or one-to-one meetings or a brainstorming session with the customer. And finally, the system analyst should be capable of analyzing the gathered requirements and search for inconsistencies, incompleteness, or ambiguities within the requirements. If any such scenario evolves, then he or she should be reporting it back to the customer again for further clarification. Once it is clarified, it needs to be written down in an SRS. This is also known as requirement elicitation. Now, what are the role of analyst basically? Role of analyst is to observe the existing systems. Observation of existing system essentially means that what are the systems which are currently running in context to that particular project. Then studying the existing procedures, discussing with the customer and end users, and analysis of what needs to be done. So these are some of the roles of the analysts which will help the analyst to perform the necessary requirement gathering and analysis process. So without the study of existing systems, it is almost next to impossible to generate or design a completely new one for the customer, because studying of existing system gives us a first-hand idea of what the existing functionalities are and what all needs to be addressed or what problems needs to be solved. So the activities which pertains to requirement gathering and analysis basically relates to study of the existing documentation. This documentation relates to the documentation which is provided by the customer in context to his project. The next is interview. Interviews can be any process which involves a brainstorming session with the customer related to the requirements, or maybe a question answer round, or maybe a questionnaire that needs to be filled up, or maybe a particular form which needs to be filled out. Basically, this interview relates to the discussions with the customer in context to his project related to requirements. The next activity is the task analysis. Task analysis refers to the various tasks that will be associated with that particular project. It might be designing, it might be coding, it might be documenting, it might be error correction, etc. Then comes scenario analysis. Scenario basically refers to the various scenarios or the various case studies which is going on around that particular project. And those scenarios needs to be discussed thoroughly because they might have certain dependency on the new project that needs to be developed. And finally is the form analysis. So here the analyst will be giving out certain forms to the customer to fill it up for the requirement gathering phase. And in that form, the customer needs to mention the various requirements in a systematic manner. So moving ahead, in the absence of a working system, basically a lot of imagination and creativity is required. When there are no such systems available, existing systems available, the developers need to use their own creativity and imagination in order to develop that particular software. If there is an existing system, it is better because there are some sort of relevancy and we can actually get an idea or a quick guide to what needs to be developed. However, in the absence of such kind of system, the imagination and creativity will be playing a key role. And then interacting with the customer to gather relevant data, it requires a lot of experience. Not just anyone can be deployed or designated for having a discussion with the customer, because we have to understand that the customer plays a very vital role. We cannot afford to have a discussion with the customer and consume his valuable time without having a fruitful discussion related to the project. So definitely it will require a lot of experience in order to maneuver and brief out the various features in context to the development of the project. There are some desirable attributes of a good system analyst, which means the system analyst cannot be a normal developer or any other person in the organization, but definitely he needs to have certain qualities before he can actually approach the customer. So first of all, he should have good interaction and communication skills so that his intention is clear from whatever he speaks. The second is imagination and creativity. This is important from the perspective that if there are no existing systems related to the project, the system analyst will be able to direct and help out the customer in order to identify his requirements as well. And the third important part is experience. So without definite amount of experience related to the field, a person will not be able to be deployed as a system analyst. So these three important attributes of a good system analyst plays a very vital role in selecting the system analyst, because he is the first point of contact of the customer and he will be able to analyze things in a better way. If an inexperienced analyst is given a chance, it might be so that there might be some things which might be oversighted by the particular analyst. So the main purpose of requirement analysis and gathering and specification phases to clearly understand the requirement, user requirements, and detect inconsistencies, ambiguities, and incompleteness. So basically, clearly understanding the user requirements, as already discussed, it involves a number of interview sessions and one-to-one meetings with the user to identify his requirements and then detect the inconsistencies, ambiguities, and incompleteness. So incompleteness and inconsistencies are further resolved through discussions with the end users and customers. So once the end users and customers are reported of the incompleteness and inconsistencies, they sit for another brainstorming session in order to sort out these particular defects in the gathered information, because in presence of this information which is not complete and consistent, it might be so that the project is poorly developed or it might fail. So the first part is, what do you mean by an ambiguous requirement? So some part of the requirement has contradictory statements, like one customer says turn off the heater and open the shower when the temperature crosses 100 degrees centigrade. Another customer says turn off the heater and turn on cooler when the temperature crosses 100 degrees centigrade. So in both of these statements, basically, it is essential that the heater should be turned off once the temperature crosses 100 degrees centigrade. However, the second important action which needs to be taken, that is opening of the water shower and turning on the cooler. So both these statements differ. However, the conditions remain same for both of the cases. So hence, for the same situation, two different solutions or two different functions needs to be carried out and has contradiction between them. So this is known as ambiguous requirement. The next is incomplete requirement. So some requirements are generally omitted, possibly due to oversightedness. The analyst has not recorded when temperature falls below 90 degrees centigrade. So When the temperature falls below 90 degrees centigrade, the heater should be turned on or the water shower should be turned off. So basically these two conditions will not be executed because the customer has or the analyst has not recorded what will happen when the temperature falls below 90 degree centigrade. So in presence of such kind of incomplete requirement, these two features will not be executed, or these two features will not be included in that particular project, which might lead to an incomplete product development. The final part is inconsistent requirement. So some requirements are basically contradictory, and this should have been inconsistent requirement. So some of the requirements are basically contradictory and related to the product features or project features, and these requirements basically have inconsistency associated to it. That means parents giving different amount of pocket money to the same age students. So this is just an example. Suppose two students are of same age, but there is not a consistent amount of behavior shown to both the students, though their prerequisites or though their preconditions are the same. So such kind of situations occur basically in inconsistent type of requirement, and has to be addressed immediately by the system analyst, because in order to identify which case should be there is extremely important in terms of the consistent and completeness of that particular project. So that is all for today. Thank you. We will continue in our next session with the software requirement specification document.